Right. Hello and welcome back to Elden Ring. Sir, we are continuing on. Last time we beat Godric, finally. And we are now ready to take on... first of all, we need to go and get his rune cashed in. So we need to go to the tower. And then, we probably want to... It might be worth testing our metal against that dragon, to be honest. So I want to head over to... Now, where is it? Ah! I guess I left myself in the area last time. Okay. So. We'll be traversing the bridge. No, we are not going to even attempt to kill these. Not yet, anyway, at least. I think one day we'll be able to. It's not today. Like, I know for example, straight away I can kill the archer. Like, we've done that before. Ooh! Took a hit. Doesn't even do like a ton, does it? It's the ones with the melee weapons that we have difficulty with those. And yeah, it's just the giant, just these massive attacks that they do. That we can't do much about, that if they touch us, put us immediately to low, and so on. So hopefully this opens for us now. And it does. That drooping down from the ceiling, eh? Lift ahead. And this is... treasure chest ahead, behind. Pickle. I mean, you're gonna check. I mean, what are you gonna do? Not check? No, you check, but if they're lying, you just disparage the message. Nice and simple. Now, where are we headed here then? I mean, obviously to the top of the tower, but. Sight of Grace and what else? Well, there's a texture loading seam if I've ever seen one. And over there. First of crouch and then let there be done. Just squat and poo. Nah. Alright, right, okay. We'll head up here. And hopefully we don't have to fight our way through this, but... Godric's great rune. It So what is this? I don't know. It's something. Did they jump off? Yep. I jumped off and left a pretty corpse. Right. There doesn't look to be much. So what exactly did we get? Remembrance of a graphic tape, however, name saved by a finger reader. I mean, we can like play as a boss against other players or something. I doubt it does, but if it did mean that, Mimic's Veil. Okay. It doesn't have a number of uses to it. See, this has got a 1 next to it, so this can be used once. Well, we only have one of them, but yeah, it even says up at the top here, reusable, consumable. Yeah. So we can just, that'll be interesting in PvP. If we ever decide to do that, which I might do toward the end, you never know. Could have a dabble. Right. So where is this great rune? Does it go in a particular slot? There it is. Item effect raises all attributes. Okay. I guess we don't fully know, but they said they'd let us in on this at the table. So, now that we've got one of these great runes, we'll head back and we will talk to everyone here.
Ah, well then.
Nothing from him.
Be sure to tell me if you meet a young woman named Lanya. She's a servant to my house. She's been my companion. I've lost count of the number, honestly.
And we don't get anything from... Hello.
Greetings. Nice to see you again. My name is Roderica. I should have told you sooner.
This person who was.
Isn't this place impressive?
Cowering that rubble.
The round table hold. Covert quarters of the two fingers. And gathering place of champions who vie to become Elden Lord. I never knew the guidance bestowed upon us Tarnished had such fantastic roots. Although, it's all a bit much for me, in truth. I'm still looking for my own purpose.
Right, and over here we have our smithy.
Now, look at you. Those eyes tell a story of a challenger who's failed her mark. Fine and well. Now lay out your arms.
Heh, we can almost do it again. Level it up and such, eh? And we've got plenty of smithing stone ones now if we wish to do up another weapon. Is there anything about anyone down here by any chance? No. Just eyes to my head, eh? I'm betting that they're lying to me. Yes, they are. I never accidentally used that. Right, cover. Yet to find out what's in there, eh? Them here.
I am pleased to see you again. Would you like me to hold you? The blessing is still aflame in your breast, dear. Would you like to be held? Then good day to you.
Who here? Was this locked before? I believe it was. Oh.
Are you that new tarnished? You've done well. I am Enya, the finger reader. I interpret the words of the fingers. Envoys to the greater will. Look there. The fingers tremble to welcome you, Shardbearer. Let their wisdom wash over you.
Great Elden Ring. Root of the Golden Order. Anchor of all lands. Giver of grace. Wellspring of all joy. Until it was shattered, the tragic corruption of the Order has taken its toll. Across the realm, life lies in ruin, fallen to pieces. Foul curses and misery spread, unabating. But the greater will has not abandoned the realm. Nor the life that inhabits it. So it is that the Tarnished are guided by grace. Called to act. Brave Tarnished. Your great rune is a handsome shard of the Elden Ring. Seek another of its kind.
To become Elden Lord and restore the Golden Order.
Let the words of the fingers guide you.
Cramped area. Didn't expect enemy. Yeah, that is something. So literally, the Order of the Two Fingers and all the fingered stuff that, well, all the finger remedies and all the finger stuff up till now, it's literally two giant fingers that can, like, telepathically talk to those weird priest ladies. I believe, wasn't she, like, part of a statue down here? Not all that long ago. Still can't talk to them. No, it's not them. Odd, then. Very odd. So what does this guy have to say then, now that we have part of the Elden
Ring? You've received the wisdom of the Two Fingers, have you not? Then, just as promised, I bid you welcome. As a true member of the Round Table, I am known as Gideon Ofnir. As a Tarnished who wishes to stand before the Elden Ring and become Elden Lord, I am accumulating knowledge. to be all-knowing. You now belong to a select group of fellows. As such, I ask that you remain constant. You'll be after more great runes now, eh? Then, as your fellow, allow me to divulge a little knowledge. The inheritors of the great runes, the shard bearers, we of the Round Table know the location of five of them, including the one you defeated. Godric the Grafted, Lord of Stormvale. General Radahn, who fought Melania and her rot to a standstill in the Caelid Wilds. Praetor Rykard, Lord of the Volcano Manor of Mount Gelmir. Morgoth, the Grace Given, Veiled Monarch and Lord of Lame Dell. And Renala, Queen of the Full Moon, ruler of Rhea Lucaria's Academy. You'll still be after more great runes, won't you? So, Godric the Grafted, Lord of Stormvale. Despite being the blood of Godfrey, first Elden Lord, he's a grotesque old fool grasping for power. His castle lies upon the cliff to Limgrave's northwest, but I suspect you know that well enough already.
Right.
General Radahn, the famed Red Lion and Scourge of the Stars, is a ferocious warrior. He fought Melania and her rot to a standstill in the Caelid Wilds to Limgrave's east. And now Caelid has been engulfed by the Scarlet Rot. Even approaching the region is no mean feat. I've heard survivors of Radahn's army are still in the wilds, staving off the rot with fire. And if it's true, I suspect Radahn is still there as well, in Caelid. Though, I doubt he much resembles his former self anymore. Praetor Rykard is the Lord of the Volcano Manor on Mount Gelmir. He is a ruthless justiciar who commands a company of inquisitors, reviled for his serpentine demeanor. The volcano, Mount Gelmir, lies in the west of the Altus Plateau, the realm of the Erd Tree. It was the stage of the most appalling battle in the entirety of the Shattering. Rykard has committed the grave sin of blasphemy, marking himself as an enemy never to be forgiven. Morgoth the Grace Given is Lord of Laendel, the capital city.
Oh, we've got a
it lies at the foot
there,
of the Erd Tree, in the east of the Altus Plateau. But the Two Fingers forbid us from venturing there, until we've acquired enough great runes to repair the Elden Ring. Set your sights elsewhere for the time being. The Veiled Monarch can wait. The Academy of Rhea Lucaria lies to Limgrave's north, towering over the mist-laden lands of Liurnia.
And we've just
Renala
that,
is queen of the Carian royals, who govern the Academy. But Renala herself is no demigod. Her beloved Radagon left her to become Queen Marika's second husband, taking the title of King Consort. The Great Rune dwells within the Amber Egg that was Radagon's gift to her.
Bit of lore then. Right. So we'll want to be on our way, but we will just talk to a few people before we go. If they have any more to say.
Well, I see. A remembrance of gold has found its way into your possession. Demigods and even the Crater of the Champions are hewn by the Erd Tree upon their end into remembrances. They are valuable indeed. These remembrances yet house the power of their former masters. And should you wish to wield that same power, well, I will lend you the strength of the fingers. Oh, do not recoil from my offer. The fingers guide us all. And you, Tarnished, you are here to take, are you not?
Right, let's see what we've got. Great runes.
Runes are the stuff of demigods. The children of the goddess, Queen Marika. She who is vessel of the Elden Ring. Tainted by the strength of their runes, her children warred, but none could become Elden Lord. And so grace was extended to your kind, the Tarnished. Listen, the fingers speak.
The greater will has long renounced the demigods. Tarnished, show no mercy. Have their heads. Take all they have left.
Indeed. But remember one thing. The demigods are each and all the direct offspring of Queen Marika. Godric the Grafted was but a distant relation, the runt of the litter. His divine blood sorely diluted.
Right, so he's just the first mini-boss. And we're going to have way bigger challenges ahead, as you would expect. It's not going to get easier as you go through a game, eh? With Power of the Remembrance menu, you can draw the Power of the Remembrance's namesake. Each can provide you with one power. Once that power is claimed, the Remembrance will be lost. Ah, but we can duplicate them, can't we? Ah, okay.
Now go forth.
Gots to go. I've got something incredibly stupid I need to do, which I'm very much looking forward to. Right. Let us depart. The merchant shack. Because in the end, I have one remembrance. And we can have two remembrances. Should have where would it be? Here we are. Two. To the power of its namesake by a finger reader. I also want to note that now I've been looking up the area here. And I'm looking at this Tomb Sword Ruins. Now apparently the Tomb Sword Ruins doesn't actually have anything there of interest. I don't think we can actually help that person. Not from what I've seen online. Just like having a bit of a quick read online. There were nothing on it, which means either no one's found out yet, or it can't be done. I have, however, found something interesting, which was while I was reading up on it, one thing kept coming up. Instead of it coming up with Tomb Sword ruins, it was Tomb Sword Catacombs. Which, if I remember rightly, was somewhere, I think around here-ish, but there's apparently a sort of cave around here that leads into some ruins you can search through. Basically a little mini dungeon that we can do. Is that just ruin fragments? No, sanctuary stone. Right. Nice. So. I can't remember exactly where it was, but I think it was... I know that you could see that in the background of it, in the entrance. Is that an item up there as well? That ruin. So I want to say that it's somewhere along this cliff, and there's like an entrance to it. I'm not certain though. Admit, I'm highly doubtful that there's I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to find it first. It doesn't look like it's along there. Maybe further along. Is it here? No. Unfortunately not. All I remember from when I was looking this up is it was that tree was in view behind it. And it's like in the side of a cliff or mountain or something. Definitely something there, isn't it? Yeah. Well, they're still following me all this way. I guess flying enemies will see you longer. It looks like it was just, First off, listen carefully and then try jump attack. As always, scarab. So yeah, it's just a scarab that jumps out at you, I guess. No, I can't find it. I'll have to look it up. I'll have another little check. I'm wondering if it's around one of the other sides, but... go back and we'll get the power from both of those rooms. Well, remembrances actually, sorry. So we'll go back, we'll see if we can get power from both remembrances. Is this perhaps it? Jellyfish, are they guarding an entrance? An item in there and an enemy. Crush the bones once they're dead. Right. Beware of group. Hear them. This is why the slowly heal yourself thing is real good, because now I don't necessarily need to use a potion. Just kind of let that ride a little while and we'll recover. Okay. Sounds ominous. Fire trap again. It's actually gonna hit this guy. backstab on this one. Weird hitbox on the ground. Right, that looks to be most of it. Let's buy some contraption. You don't. Gotcha. Okay, that was worth it. Ooh, we can now make fire arrows. We can make a lot of fire arrows. We can make a lot of fire arrows that are fletched. Ooh. Okay. Quite a lot of good stuff we're getting in here now. One herb leaf flowers create those fur call and finger remedies. Herb leaf flowers are quite common as well. I could literally make 15 of those right now. There's me thinking they're quite rare. But yeah, I've literally done this entire thing with zero health loss, basically. I'm not missing something here, am I? I mean, obviously I'm missing something. It's locked by some contraption. presumably that's somewhere in here. See, this is where I could actually use a bit of guidance from notes on the floor. And there's none to be found. It's worth pointing out as well, there's an entire upstairs there that I've not even gotten to. So I'm thinking I'm nowhere near done here. Let me get a secret wall. Oh no, a lion ahead. Interesting. Yeah, you must be able to get up there because there's plants and things. So I'm not done here, am I? Must have missed something. Maybe there's a path I've not taken yet. Any corridors, signs, or ladders. It's not just a case that I have to like smack those out of the hands or something, is it? Very odd. Peculiar. Something I have to look up and find out somewhere. Looks like it's got me a bit stumped about there's nothing obvious to do there. Yeah, these are loose, aren't they? To find. So I should probably start using the co-op a lot more often. but will leave me open to invaders. Right. Well, I think we'll be calling it here. But before I go, find out what this remembrance does, and then probably call it for an episode. I'm half tempted to just go and try throwing myself at that dragon and seeing if I can make a scratch on it. Now that I've got all this fire resistance. Revived. Received power. Oh, what's that? Strength and faith is required. Oh, I see. So we can turn it. So rather than last time where this were a bit obscure how you did this, because I know in Demon Souls you would get a great soul, and you'd typically get these in Dark Souls and things, you'd get a powerful soul and you could take it and use it either for to get runes, well, souls in those games, you'd get souls, or you would take it to a smith, but only particular smiths, only certain ones, and they would turn it into some kind of super weapon. But you had to find the correct weapon, you wouldn't know which, and it would only start using that soul when you were upgrading it past a certain point. So you had to buy the correct weapon, upgrade it far enough, and then it would offer to use the soul to turn it into a specific weapon or item or whatever. Which I can see why they'd change that, because that is, I mean, you'd have to either have played the game a bunch or have just looked it up in a wiki or seen it on YouTube to probably know that without it telling you, which is a bit dumb. But this is a better system from the looks of it. So we can get one of these, or we can, I guess, you can duplicate them like we have and get both. So we would need more strength and faith to use this, and we'd need more of both dex and strength to use this. We can use neither of these items. I mean, I'm gonna go for the fire thing, of course. And that also cost money as well. And we'll
go for that door.
So that's our boss reward. Now, let's have a look. And we've got, now is that a shield of some sort? Or an offhand weapon? Now where is it actually? Oh, it's there. Right, so let's just put it in our main hand then. And we'll try them out. Can we still walk down here and go back up? Ooh! Lights up a bit, that's cool. And a big stomp. Right, okay. And that's called, what move is that? Oh, it's literally, it's I command thee kneel. So that's his big stomp. Right. Or otherwise, we have. So it just swings, and then you can hit him with that. It cannot be dual wielded. Interesting. Interesting. So it's not designed as a main hand weapon. Which makes sense. He should be able to wield both of his weapons. Because he did. I imagine that if he had the right stats, that would probably set on fire. Literally right now, we don't even use up FP or anything while we do that, because it's obviously clearly doing nothing. So if we want to use those, it's going to be strength and faith, and then some dex obviously for the Axe of Godrick. So these are all, you know, big. Big, hefty, we need tons of strength to wield them weapons. You know, colossal sword. Great. So we've got things here like a great sword with claymore. But obviously, you know, great axe, colossal swords, and so on. Anyway. Fine with this for now. But we may wish to... We may wish to soon swap out our weapon that we're using. But it might be some time before we do. Oh. Who's this then? There's a new person, eh?
Ah, we meet again after all. I apologize for any offense given by my bearing,
person,
but I'm quite unable to move, you see. So,
oh no, it's not.
What do you need?
Oh, we've been stuck in something. It's the sorcerer from the church that we were in. Middle of Godric's, well, Stormvale Castle. So we can now get his wares from here. So, spinning weapon. Usable on small and medium swords, axes and hammers, as well as polearms and staves. Grants affinities to skills, grants affinities and skills to an armament. Grants affinities and skills to that. So Ash of War, Karen Greatsword. Usable on colossal weapons. Usable on swords. Colossal weapons are accepted. So that means, I guess, no colossal swords can be used for this. And then there's a glintstone pebble. Usable on swords and polearms, capable of thrusting. And it'll, I assume, shoot some magic out. The projectile toward them. Oops, okay. We'll see if we can talk to her again.
Pleasure to see you. Thank goodness you're safe. I'm still looking for my own purpose. It's not easy by any means. But it's what I must do.
Not much to say, right. I think that's going to be it for the episode. But mind you, I did mention, I suppose it depends how much we've got in terms of... Oh yeah, we've got 42, I do not care about losing 42. Let's test our might. then we might, if it's available, go for it next episode. What can we do against the dragon? Because I would love to know. Maybe we may be able to call some co-op partners in. We may be able to do this. I dare say indeed we might be able to manage this. If only we could get those wolves, eh? Maybe worth putting some points into that. Get him! And distraction game. I've got the right idea. We might be able to do that. If not now, then shortly. Definitely the flame drop. Alright, okay. Put it down there though. And I'm dead. Rabid dogs. Oh, they're like big Scotty dogs. Big angry ones that eat your face off. Ugh. the dog. Target the dogs. Jesus Christ. Got him. Taken care of. Ooh, very nice. Uh-oh, dog. No shortage of your items. Goods are relative too. Is that all the... Might be all the loot though. At least all the good loot. Now when they're saying the feral flame of Akeel, is Akeel a dragon? Should probably pay more attention while looking at his name on the health bar bottom or whatever. Well, again, last time it took us somewhere good. This time, maybe not so much. We'll find out. But I've only got a couple hundred runes. I'm not fussed about losing them. You know, when we need like 8,000 or 9,000 to actually... Oh, this is taking me somewhere great. What the hell is gravity stuff? Okay, these miners are clearly tougher than the other miners. Significantly tougher than the other miners. But I presume... Oh. Right. I wonder if those transporter traps take you. I'm gonna say anywhere if it's the same spot. I'm reckoning we want to head up and out toward probably want to go up and try to get out of the mine. So we'll probably want to make a start on that soon enough. Yeah. But first we're gonna have to obviously do something. Very good job, I noticed that. Okay, that shield works really good. Each enemy here is worth hundreds of runes. These smithing stones are no joke that we're getting here. Now these transporter traps are not necessarily bad things. If you can handle it and be cautious, you can get high level gear early on. Does not look good. They're aware of me. Let's hope not. Anyway, I should probably be using this. Stone. archer. A bit the ability they're using, won't it? Right, nice. Well, we're going back up, which is, I guess, what we're wanting to do here. That's where I came from. I missed out on that item there, him there, but what I want to do is find a site of grace, really. We'll try to fight one at once here. That literally went through with it. Yeah, I don't know. Git. And that other one's caught on to us. Their backs have turned. Theirs wasn't. Come on, come get some. That's going to be an arena, isn't it? Death ahead. Which means that the way out should be... Where is the way out? It's not there. Just want to leave. Right, that's going to do it for the episode, though. Even though I wanted to kind of get to a site of grace before leaving, we'll have to leave it there. So, we'll have to find a way out. It will probably be up, and that looks like it's a boss. So, yeah. Maybe it's down to get out? I don't know. I'm a bit lost, needless to say. But we're calling it there. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.